Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You're watching ProTech. Last time we reviewed generic HyperOS 2.0.5 build, which is booted on my OnePlus 9 RT, but as that ROM is ported build from Xiaomi's ultra device running with Chinese HyperOS build, last build have lots of Chinese steps. Even after first boot, everything was in Chinese language. It have Xiaomi account login issues and some customization steps are missing. But if you don't like Chinese stuff and want global version of HyperOS which solved most of those annoying bugs, I got another bootable working HyperOS 2.0.6 EU version. Today in this video we are going to review which are interesting stuff this build have, which bugs are solved in this build, and at the end I have discussed some bugs of this build and my final verdict about this ROM, which will definitely blow your mind. So watch this video till the end. Now with the further delay, let's get started. Remember, this is a vendor specific JSON ROM ported by Mystic Developers team. Booting such JSA builds needs permissive kernel with AVB disabled. Even after following all of requirements, sometimes these ROMs didn't boot on all of devices. So I always recommend you to try it using DOC loader, and if it boots and working well on your device, then only follow installation of this ROM via first boot method. Both of video tutorials are given in the description. I booted this ROM on my OnePlus 9RT. Let's first check out device details of this build. This is Xiaomi's EU HyperOS 2.0.6 beta version. This is Android 15 build with May 2025 security patches, except that device name and its specifications are detected by this build correctly. Kernel version will remain same as stock primary ROM. Let's quickly review why this build is better than old build. Immediately after first boot, everything will be in the English. You don't have to go to settings and need to change device language. Even we get the pre-installed Google services in this ROM. In the setting, we can add Google account and can enjoy all steps of Google services like Google Cloud synchronization. Google Play Store with all working Google applications are available in this ROM. Next, as the last build ported from Chinese version of HyperOS, we can't able to use Theme Store and can't able to add other customization steps. But now in personalization setting, some new live and super wallpapers are available which look stunning. By using find more option, we can download new live, super and dynamic wallpapers which are not working in a previous version. You also get lots of amazing wallpaper here. Once you get your desired wallpaper, download it and then tap on apply button. That's it. Now enjoy the amazing animations of super and dynamic wallpapers while locking and unlocking your device. Even we can able to add new widgets in this build, especially these paid widgets. These are interactive widgets which responds to your touch and reacts in a different styles every time. For me, it's funny and looking interesting to use such things because I had seen such things in a smartphone first time. Performance of this ROM is of next level. Everything is buttery smooth, even though I am using only 8 GB of user data partition using DOC loader. Imagine how ROM will work if we run this build as a primary ROM on our device. All interesting stuffs of HyperOS are working in this build, like side toolbox which offers application sidebar, in-game toolbar and video toolbar. This resembles with the sidebar of OnePlus 15 and works same like features of sidebar. We can able to open applications in multi-window using this feature. Even we can open application drawer anytime using side toolbox. All multitasking features similar like OnePlus are available in this ROM. Even who gets the advanced video toolbox which is accessible via side toolbox when you are watching videos in any application. Even who gets the advanced game toolbox when you play games. This one is also similar to the game space of OnePlus 15. I am not going to discuss all features of HyperOS again in this video. Please check out our old HyperOS video. There I reviewed all of major customizations of HyperOS. All essential features are working in this build, like Wi-Fi, GPS, NFC, Bluetooth on my device. Surprisingly, 5G network with VoNR calls are also working on my OnePlus 9RT, which was buggy in previous version. So let's discuss which things are buggy and not working for me. First one is a punch hole camera issue. There are double punch hole cutout are present in this ROM. One is on the left and another one is on center. I think devices with center punch hole cutout will not get such issue. This bug is unsolvable even after I tried punch hole cutout option available in the display setting of this ROM. Or you can use dark wallpaper and theme to hide this center punch hole cutout. Xiaomi's account login bug is solved in this build, but even after login this setting force closes for few times, but later it works perfectly. Except these under display fingerprint and face unlocks are not working, so you have to use pattern or password unlock for security of your device. Except these bugs, everything is working for me on my 9RT. Bugs may vary as per device you are using. This new global HyperOS version seems much better option if someone wants to try new stock ported HyperOS, which have lots of OnePlus 15 features, so you can enjoy beauty of both worlds. I already booted lots of stock GSR ROMs, but they have lots of bugs. That's why I only release a build which have least bugs, and it feels nearly stable like this HyperOS version. This is all about for today, guys. Hope you liked our work. Then please do like and share this video. Subscribe to our channel. Press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming mod content. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye bye.